Sir, you can start.
Sir, okay, sir. A very good morning to one and all present here. Welcome back. And this is our first session in this FDP program. So we here have Dr. Somashekhar, sir, with us to address the session. Hearty welcome to you, sir.
Thank you so much.
May I take this opportunity to brief the profile of Dr. Somashekhar S. Hiremath. Dr. Somashekhar received the doctoral degree in 2004 from IIT Madras, Chennai, Tamil Nadu, India. He has published more than 150 papers on national and international level. He has delivered more than 75 invited talks on various topics of his research at engineering colleges, universities, research centers, industries, and conferences. Currently, he is handling many consultancy and sponsored projects of various industries and R&D institutions of Defence, Government of India. His current research areas are mechatronic system design, system simulation and modeling, robotics, finite element modeling, basically fluid structure interactions, micro machining, advanced machining process, basically hybrid process and fluid power systems. His awards and honors are Innovative Student Project Award in the year 2005, Best PhD Thesis of the year 2004-5 in Mechanical Engineering Department from Indian National Academy of Engineering, New Delhi. And he has received Professor K. Armugam National Award for Innovative Research Work in Engineering and Technology from ISTE, New Delhi. So he has received Certificate of Achievement for Guiding Best MS Thesis in Mechanical Engineering from Indian National Academy of Engineering, New Delhi. He has also received Certificate of Achievement for Guiding Best MS Thesis in Mechanical Engineering from ISTE, New Delhi. And his contributions continues in the teaching fraternity. We are happy to have you, sir. So we kindly request you to take over the session, please.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Shall I share my slide now?
Yes, sir. You can share your screen.
Yeah, yeah. Who is with me now until end? In between, I'll ask you because of the internet connectivity loss or something, you know, sometimes you are not seeing me. Who is with me now until end? Can you please name one? Prabhudas?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You are with me?
Sir, Arun Kumar, sir, will be there.
One second.
Kumar. I'll also, yes.
Who is there? Shanmugam Kumar,
sir.
Oh, Shanmugam Kumar is with me. One second.
Yeah,
yes,
since bus more than enough. I'm very happy. Shanmugam Sundar with me until end. Correct? Another 1 hour or 1.5 hours. Okay, thank you so much. So many faculty are there, you know, for this FDP. Very interesting FDP it is, you know, because it is a need of our now. All we are facing a lot of problem in online teaching and a smart classroom and a digital teaching. Correct? This is the main theme of the workshop, Shanmugam. Correct? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, yeah, correct. In between, I'll ask you a small thing to
yes,
you.
Sir.
Okay, you have to guide me. Yes. This is the main agenda of the whole FDP, correct? How to face the things currently. We are, all our teachers are there. Many people are there. You know, Arjun is there. Karthik is there. Very nice. Now, can you please tell me? Now, I'm also seeing your chat box also now.
Yes,
1 minute. What you are expecting from me in the talk? Can you please list out any faculty are there? What you want to expect from me in the role of teachers in the digital age? Now it is a mandatory, it is not a previously it is may or may not. Now it is a mandatory, we have to believe in the digital age. Correct, can you please, you know, friends, at least one or two words you will type me.
Sir, can I ask, sir?
Please, madam ji, please.
Good morning, sir. I'm Vaidegi, yeah. Patrician College, Commerce Faculty, sir.
Excellent.
It's really very nice, you know, to meet the students in e-platform, and yeah. I can also see a lot of changes. But my only question is the reachability, sir. We can't see the body language and the listening mode of students. So I'm really worried about the listening skills of the students. Kindly invite me in this aspect, sir.
Excellent, excellent, excellent. Definitely, definitely we'll address these things, madam ji. And then some other some other people. I want to very nice thing, madam, what she told. This is one of the things what we have to facing lot of problem in the e-teaching, correct? Students are sitting somewhere else, we are sitting somewhere else, as if we are talking with the our computer and tables and chairs. What madam is telling is also correct. Body language is very difficult nowadays. We are not, until as a teacher, you know, we are accustomed with the various body language, meaning in the wording itself, you know, when we are telling very exaggerated thing, very low pitch, high pitch, medium pitch, these are very, very essential in the teaching. What madam told is very good. How to address, I'll tell you minimal things in the online teaching now. Okay, next, what we are expecting others, people, please. Very nice question. I will try to do it, madam ji. No need to worry now. Okay. Some other who, what you want, expecting from me? What are the tools for connectivity? Yes, sir. Yes, there are various tools are there for connectivity. So many platforms are there. I will tell you now how to make the people to connect. Okay. Then some more I am expecting. Some more, one or two. Connectivity tools are very essential now. Now you already know some of the popular free tools are Google, Zoom, correct? Many things are there, Microsoft, many things are there. We'll discuss now how best we have to do it. But these are not the paid one it is. Now we are facing a lot of problems, friends, correct? Because connectivity to the minimum number of people, many things are there, correct? We'll see now. Okay, next.
Sir, hello, sir. I am Mengada Sudhakar. Hello.
Please, sir. Please tell me, sir, please.
Yes, Mengada Sudhakar, sir, tell me. Yes, sir. I am from Eltech University.
Excellent.
Actually, online platform teaching is very difficult, but evaluation is more than teaching, sir. The difficulties of evaluation is more than the teaching. So how we solve this problem?
Professor, not only for you, it is for we also. Meaning, you know, it is more work is there, but it is having so many advantages. And as a teacher,
are also involving malpractice.
I will tell you, same thing, sir. In IIT also, we are facing all these problems, what you are telling now. You know, I will address these things. These are some of the pros and cons are there. But what I am telling is now, it is a mandatory. It is no other way. We should not escape from the these things. You know, what they will call online teaching is a mandatory. COVID made us to learn many things. Through use of these media to convey our data to the students. One more thing you'll remember, friends, all we are teachers. We are having a big respect from the student community. Now, what we have to do, how best we have to reach the student, we have to see. These things are there. No, we are also facing what my sir told, malpractice, all these things. 100% it is. E-teaching, you know, we can't do anything now because we have to be with the waves. But now what IIT is doing, sir, we are collaborating with the TCS ION this time only. Last semester, we did like you, what you are telling online. Then we told the student to switch on your videos until end. Many students have written the feedback such a way that, no, we should not switch on because, you know, we are sitting in the house. How our house is there, you know, not in the good condition, all these things. Why we want to show to you? Many, many resistances are there. Our director, sir, asked two positive points for online and two negative points for the online. All students are writing, we should not switch on our videos during writing the exam. Also, the connectivity problem, as madam told, many connectivity issues are there. I don't know how many hours I'm connecting to you people, even though I'm sitting in IIT. Many times during the class hours, we are lost the connectivity. Simply, we are talking. You know, students are not hearing anything. Also, one more thing is, as my sir told, malpracticing is, now it is there, no other way. But now IIT, what it is doing, I told, we are conducting this exam physically in TCF ION. We identified the TCF ions throughout India, some of the places, colleges. The student has to go to the nearby college during the exam hour. They have to write a 3 hours exam. But all teaching mode, learning mode through our online only. No excuse for that. But writing exam we made physically. But there also many who are students will not study. No, they will resist this. We are difficult to access to the what you will call TCF ION centers and how to reach within time. Many problems are there. I am not telling you. But you know, friends, you believe it or not, MHRD, the government of India, made a tool. You have to come up with best result from the students. That is the one thing. We'll see now how best it is. It is having so many advantages and so many disadvantages are there. I will give you some clear picture what is going on in IIT and other country also. Okay. Now, one more friend is writing how to engage actively throughout the session. Throughout. Very nice. This is one more thing, friends. Very, very nice question it is. How will you make active ourselves during the talk? Here, nobody will give tablet to you to make active, because no students are there, nothing is there. You have to make yourself active to teach the subject. Even though you are not seeing the student, what you will do know in between. The one more biggest problem is the students are all switch on their meaning they will enter the room and they will switch off video and they will sleep. They will not listen also. That is a thing. Now very difficult to monitor, take the attendance. So many attendance tools are there, proxy attendance, how their students are giving in the colleges. Same thing here also. When they will come inside the room, in a Google Meet or any room, attendance will be ensured because they will enter. How much they are listening, how much what they are doing, it is very difficult. But as a teacher, it is not our duty, leave it. You will teach, sir, even though 50 students are there, the 5 good students are there, they are learning through active learning. If this process will go continuously, we will get the better results, what I am telling. Because the students will also know that apart from this, we can't learn anything. This is a no other way. This is a mode now. You people knows you are in Anna University. This time they made this semester also all online classes. This COVID teached many things, friends, not only in the academics, all sphere, it teaches many things to us. We'll discuss some of the things. Then any other, what you're expecting from me? Then so many teachers are there, elder teachers are there. And younger teachers, younger faculty colleagues are there, who are elder teachers are there, their way of teaching and their expectation is very big because they are big gurus. They are expecting Gurukul systems to be adopted. Now we are in the digital age. You can't expect the Gurukul system. What is a Gurukul system? I will tell you now during my talk. Then tell me what you are expecting some other people. Shanmugesh, Shanmugam.
Yes, sir. Good morning, sir. I'm
Dr. Yeah, very good. Namaste, sir.
Namaste, sir. Sorry for the delay, sir. I had one more class.
I'm very, a very good friend to you.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, sir.
I will make you, have to be present up to my end of the talk. 1 hour, yeah. You have to. Now physically means like this, you have to attend. Okay, no need to worry. Okay?
Take your own time.
Okay. Thank you very much, sir. Okay, now we'll start our talk, in between. One more thing, please, friends, remember, this is not addressing to any IITs or not any universities. This is a general talk, what I'm addressing now. Because all we are teaching faculty facing a lot of problems, students are facing the problems. But now it is a mandatory to accustom with this online teaching, whatever you'll call digital teachings. We'll see now in today's talk. How best we have to go about it. Okay, friends, I'll share my slide now. Okay, you tell me whether all my slides are visible or not later. Okay, I'll share now. I'm very happy. Many teachers are very eager to see the things. Now all my slides are visible, friends.
Yes, sir. Role of teachers in digital age.
Yes, sir, we'll see now what is our role of teacher. How best I am reaching the faculty, kindly, accept me as it is now. Because, no physical presence, as madam told, no, we are not in the physical to you, to see you all people. We'll begin my talk. Okay. This is, very quickly I will tell you about my laboratory, very quickly focused area, very quickly. Okay, I will move the slide very quickly because it is not an agenda of the talk. But this is a very useful for where we are working. If you people knows, you may kindly join our laboratory for the research work. Engineering it is, okay? Then I will tell you my autography, how it is, how I brought to this level. Very quickly, 2 slides, I will show you my autography. I'm requesting all the faculty colleagues, you will also recall when I'm showing my autograph. Because many elder people are there, many younger people are there. You will also recall 20 years back how it is technology and how it is now, including the teaching learning process. And I will give you some outlook on Gurukul system, modern Gurukul, English schools, and a light sum smart school and e-schools. And important traits of e-teacher. We are called as e-teachers now. And some amazing facts of teaching learning process, how it is. And concluding remarks. Let us will. Shanmugesh Sundar?
Yes, sir.
Okay. After you, please, you will note down, the faculty colleagues will note down their doubts. I'll clarify later. Okay.
Okay.
One
hour.
Okay. Now, quickly, I will show you. This is our laboratory. What you are seeing now is the Precision Engineering and Instrumentation Laboratory. We are working on the 5 major research areas: control engineering, mechatronics engineering, robotics, precision manufacturing, and hydraulics and pneumatics. Many areas are there. If you come to our laboratory, you will see that tremendous work is going in all these areas. Now, we see this, my research group is currently working on the 3 important domains. Some groups are working on design and development of the sophisticated and instrumented setups for micro and nano machining, used for machining the micro holes, micro channels, micro textures, microstructures, and further on the nanoparticle generation, hybrid nanoparticle generation, characterization and application suitability. And another group is working on the fluid power systems, friends. This is basically, we are developing the valves for the electro-hydraulic servo valve, electro-hydrostatic actuator, high pressure and low pressure pneumatics for the space application vehicles. And also we are currently concentrating more on the energy saving systems like a hydraulic hybrid systems for the automotive applications. Currently it is in need of the time, hydraulic hybrid vehicles. Then one more research group is working on the robotic systems. Here we are concentrating on the path planning, control, dynamics, and we are calibrating the many industrial and medical robots as per the ISO defined parameters. And all these objectives, friends, are successfully completed and undergoing with the help of dedicated scholars. These are the many scholars under my guidance. Many 11 PhDs are completed on these domains. And still many people are on the queue to finish their PhD programs. These are the MS scholars. Now already they are doing their PhD, and they joined many institutes for their work. Now, quickly, I'll show you. These are the glimpse of R&D facility available in our Precision Engineering Instrumentation Laboratory under my control. These are the setups. What you are seeing now in this slide is a tailor-made setup, friends. We are not having any commercial machine tools to do it. We are doing tremendous work in the micro machining areas. We have developed our micro EDM, micro electrochemical spark machining, hot air jet machining, extrude honing, hydraulic hybrid system, hydrostatic steering systems, multiple micro pumps for the flow study, VHF system, many, many things. You will see all are developed by our student based on the physical principles to develop these systems. And also we are very good in developing the robots, mobile robots, as well as parallel manipulators for the various applications. This is a furrow laser tracker available in laboratory to calibrate all industry robots as well as medical robots according to the ISO defined parameters. All these parameters are possible to calibrate in our laboratory with the help of online data measurement and calibration systems. These are the some of the work carried out in the robotics, like a trajectory tracking, the regular trajectory, like a circular, triangular, rectangular, and much more. This is carried out using the graphical user interface. This will give you the so many task. Here you will give the select anything, and you will give the dimensions. Automatically, our robots will trace the required trajectory. And you will see this is extended to cooperative robots. There are many robots are there. What you are seeing is the EPOC robots for the cooperative things to reach the destination. They will exchange the data for every instant of time between them to reach the destination, avoiding the obstacles. Obstacle avoidance strategy here. Then you will see adaptive control robots. You see one initial robot and final robots. They will follow the minimum distance to reach the destination with the help of various control algorithms. One algorithm is a waypoint navigation algorithm. Okay, these are the waypoint generated using the path planning. Here you will see the robot will follow the minimum distance to reach the obstacle by avoiding the so many obstacles placed on the 2D platforms. And also we are working on the imaging. Here's the same thing what you are seeing previously. It is controlled through the non-contact type image processing technique to monitor the position and orientation of the robot moving on the 2D platforms. There are like this, we are developing the so many algorithms. This is a bug one algorithm. Previously, avoiding the obstacle and reducing the destination. Now you will see the robot is tracing the, making the circumnavigating the obstacle. You will get the, what is the shape, size of the obstacle occurred in unstructured environment. Then it will go to the destinations. Like this, you know, two robots, three robots, you know, how they will trace the final destination, we are tracking in our laboratory. Then also we are using the advanced technologies like artificial intelligence is now number one. Here we are using the goal-seeking behavior using the reinforcement learning. Here what I am doing here, friends, I am giving the initial point and the final point. Then the robo, it will you don't know where it will go. You will define only the plane. Then robo will make the so many iterations to reach the final destination. Here you will see the convergence is at 30 iteration, it is reaching the final. Here, what is the strategy here is, if it will go away from the object what you are defined, you will get the negative rewards. If it will go towards the object, it will get the positive rewards. This is a reinforcement learning technique. And you will see here, we are defining the initial and final. The robo, by doing the 180 iteration, it will avoid all obstacles and reaching the destinations. Then also, we are extending our work to the society, like an autonomous lake cleaning intelligent robot system. Here we are using the multiple drones flying over the lake to detect the ashes. Different types of trashes are there in the lake, like a paper, sticks, bottles, all. Each is having the barcode, they will detect. And then they will send the all the information to the main system. From the main system, it will go to the marine robot, which will move to collect all the ashes, bring back to the bank. Similarly, you know, social relevance projects we are doing for reconfigurable autonomous sewage cleaning robot. Here, what we are doing, no friend, this is a reconfigurable robots to clean the sewer pipes. Big sewer pipes are there. Now currently, the human are handling the sewer blockages. They have to get down and they have to do it. Very tedious job it is. Now we are making the robots to move by themselves to clean the sewer blockages. Then these are the some of the books published on the thrust areas like electro-hydraulic servo valves, nanoparticle generation, bioimplants, and many more. Now, why I have shown you all these things is this is for the young budding faculties to join the hands for us to do the your PhD programs or MS programs. There are two times admission, February for the July admission, October for January admission. Be as a part of the research in IIT Madras because generous scholarship is there, unmatched ambience, greater career, meaning sponsorship for the participation at international conferences. Okay, now we'll move to the role of teachers in the digital age. Shanmusundar Shanmugam, I'm in line.
Yes, sir. Yeah, yes, sir.
Yeah, in between I'll ask you, sir. Why? Because if connectivity is lost, no, madam ask, no. If I lost you people, I lost everything. In between, I'll ask you whether I am in the right path or not. Okay. Yes. Now we'll see, friends. Now, this is our main talk today. You'll see here now, irrespective of the era, whether we are in Gurukul, modern Gurukul, English school, smart school, or an e-class. Please remember, friends, teacher is must, and he has a prominent role as a mentor, facilitator, educator, counselor, friend, parent, and much more, whatever you will think, friends. You don't think always you are a professor. You are now, your role is a mentor, facilitator, educator, counselor, friend, be as a friend, and be as a parent, and much more role. If you are a warden, you are a father of 1,000 students. You think all, your role is very important currently. No doubt, friends, teacher is a multidimensional, please understand. You are like a Krishna. You are like a Krishna, meaning you are a multidimensional. In framing the children's growth, in all directions and a sphere to enhance the country's growth, country's growth, development is in yours. And the Hindu mythology, if you see, princess and a princess used to go and stay with their teacher at their ashrams and gurukuls to gain a knowledge and a wisdom from them. Correct? Not in their kingdoms and houses. Gurus will never come to kingdoms and houses to teach. Now, no way we have to go to students' houses and teach. On the occasion where their learning officially ends, they were supposed to offer a Guru Dakshana to their gurus, which could be anything that teacher asked for. You know, Ekalavya, guru asked thumb. He cut and given the thumb to the guru. Such type of shishyas are there. Now, don't expect. Noteworthy, we cannot neglect the great gurus for their great personalities in framing Bhishma, Krishna, Rama, Lakshmana, Alexander, and many more. You'll recall, friends, so many people are there. They learn from the gurus. To commemorate the contribution of great teachers, 5th September every year is a Teachers' Day in India. It's celebrated on the birth anniversary of our first Vice President and a second President of India, Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan. In fact, many times a teacher status is taken to be superior to a god, as he or she teaches us the values of learning good life. Let us will remember great gurus. Please remember, friends, you are not so simple now. You are beyond. Only, you know, because, you know, all senior teachers are there. They're remembering the teachers many ways. Correct. Now we'll see Veda Vyasa. You are seeing, no? The Guru of Gurus, and the festival of Guru Purnima is dedicated to him. Please note, he was an author of the great epic Mahabharata, grandfather of both Kauravas and Pandavas. And also you will see the Parashurama, considered as a 6th avatar of Lord Vishnu and served as a mentor to Bhishma Pitamaha and Dronacharya. He taught the art of warfare to Karna, the friend of Duryodhana and the eldest son of Kunti. Dronacharya, the most popular mythological teacher, the Indian government even conferred the Dronacharya Award, an outstanding coaches in sports and games. We know already this. Dronacharya was the guru of Pandavas and Kauravas. Sandipini, teacher to Krishna and Balarama. You'll see, friends, tears are coming, correct? Krishna and Balarama studied with Sandipini. Then you'll see Vaishishtha, one of the great Saptarushis, teachers of Lord Rama, Lakshmana, Bharata, Shatrughna. Valmiki, the teacher of Lord Rama and Sita's son, Lavakush. Then Brihaspati, gurus of Devas, all, he's the guru of all Devas. Then Shukracharya, one of the famous Saptarushi, guru of Daityas or Asuras. Then Gopal Rao Maharaj, teacher of Sai Baba. Aristotle, the teacher of great warrior Alexander. Then you'll see, friends, what it will teach us. The great people, including Krishna, Rama, Balarama, you know, all they are studied with the help of teacher, even though they are the incarnation of God. God only there, correct? Even then, they are learned with gurus. Now, talk is very quickly known to unknown, as I have told you. I will recall my olden days. Friends, you will also recall that during the days of my youth, this is what we had available. Some of them are listed below because we have to accustom with this only. Don't expect more during that time. What is that? You are seeing, friends, photography. How it is? Black and white camera rolls. And you have to wait 2 to 3 days and even more because it consumes a lot of time in washing, cleaning, printing to see your pose in the projected photos. Transport, believe it or not, friends, I traveled many times in bullock cart, horse cart, tricycle. That time, most popular vehicles available is TVS, Majestic, Bajaj Chetak, LML Vespa, Maruti 800. And heavy duty buses and trucks are Tata Motors and Ashok Leyland. They are making big sounds. Then you will see the entertainment available that time is a radios and gramophone and tape recorder. Many of young faculties, they don't know what is radio. They will never hear it because now there are so many possibilities are there to explore. Later, we have seen the black and white TV. I don't think so black and white TV is available anymore now. Because, you know, that time TV means without remote. Only we have go near to TV to switch on and switch off only. Because no changing channels. Please remember, friends. As because only one channel, that is a Doordarshan from Government of India. And in between, half an hour regional language is there, like a Tamil, Kannada, Telugu, Malayali, all these things are there. Most of us, we are enjoying, no option at all. Please remember, friends. Also, friends, still I remembered every Wednesday night, 8 to 8:30 p.m., we are seeing the popular Hindi songs. We'll never miss it because we have to wait again one more week. Such type of days are there now. Now we'll see, apart from this, if you'll come to academics, is concerned, documents are prepared by hand. You believe it or not, we are making a lot of efforts in building the handwriting skills. Later, you know, typewriter and electronic typewriter, but electronic typewriters are very expensive because they will type it line and then print it. Once it is printed, not able to make any corrections. Such things are there. Then if you see the banking sector, accounting was done by the hand. And long ledgers are there for entry and exits. Long queues, you have to be there. Later, they are using the calculators. These friends, remember, I have seen a scientific calculator, FX100, in my engineering in 90s. And even I learned operations like a sine, cos, tan, sine inverse, tan inverse, with a great difficulty after discussing with my friends. When we want to communicate each other, friends, only three options. Can you please guess what are three options to meet the friends? That olden days. Now youngsters don't know. Only we are having the seek them out in person. Generally, we are meeting the friends during the breakfast time, lunch time, dinner time. As because 100% sure their mother will feed us. That is the thing what we are having that time. Then write a letter if they are away. For example, your son and children are studying. That time they are writing a letter to them. Then it is the best way of communicating our feelings. Writing letters are speaking with us. And many times we are opening and seeing again and again the letter written by our parents. Now, next affair is very quick communication is sending the telegram to them in emergency only because they are costly affairs. Use a minimal letters, friends, that time because start immediately. I'm not feeling well. Only words, meaning every word is counted and they are charging in the post office. Later, the landlines are there. Again, the only rich people are having that. We are giving the landline numbers of the others and we are attending the calls when the phone will come. Great difficulties. Later, mobile phones. As we have seen these mobile phones only in the pockets of industrialists and rich people. You believe it or not, this has happened in the 2000, friends. These mobiles are very costly affairs. When I am doing PhD in IIT Madras, in 2000, the mobiles are there with industrial pockets. That time, you know, the receiving and talking is 3 rupees per call. They will never lift our phone calls when emergency is required. Now we'll see, but now you will see, friends, things yourself, where we are now, where we are heading. You will see, friends, the transformation, the need of time. Tremendous changes, correct? We have to accept, adapt, race to current digital age. Many things are happened and happening in the world. Quickly, we'll see change in our factory layout itself. I'm showing you very quickly factory layout, meaning industrial revolution, which is very important to change our social, economic, and technological status of the country. You'll see, friends, very quickly, one slide. Industrial revolution, olden days, you'll see. Meaning here in the 18th century, friends, only availability is steam and water. All machine tools are run with steam and water. Mechanical production equipment powered by steam. Then in the industry 2.0, second generation, 19th century, electricity appeared in the market. The machine tools all drive through the electricity. Then you will see the third generation, friends. Here nuclear power and computers and various softwares, computer related things are arriving in the market. Then we are connecting all the machine tools, devices using the networks inside the factory. Meaning we are able to automate our production using the electronics, computers, and a programmable logic controller. This 20th century. Now here we are, you will see, now we are in the era of industry 4.0. It is the fourth generation, which is started after 2015 and today. Here you believe it or not, friends, no humans in the factory. All humans are known as deskless workers. Deskless workers, no space to sit here. You will control all the machines, equipment while traveling, while sleeping in the house. All are connected to the internet. This is here we are using all our cyber physical systems. Now such things are there. Now what we are doing now in Industry 4.0, we are making the all machines are intelligent. Intelligent means what? I'm mimicking my brain inside the machines. They will think and they will act based on that. Now that is our duty to make our student to think, do by themselves. We have to mimic our brain in the student mind by adopting the various techniques. But how it is happening, you may ask the question, because of the IoT evolutions, Internet of Things. Because you'll see, friends, now I'm talking, I'm sitting in IIT Madras. Many faculty colleagues are there from Chennai and other places, from city, from the state, many are there. How it is possible only due to the development in IoT, which will connect the people, connect the automobiles, connect the house, connect the cities, connect the industries. Because almost all machines and components here are cyber-physical systems. Availability of inexpensive sensors and actuators. Mobility is easy now. And cloud computing is there. No need to handle by yourself. Large data is handled by the computers. And increasing computing power is available with the possibility of powerful speed and frequency of the processors. Then also big data and analytics is possible now. Also, secured open platforms are there. As my friends told, I will tell you, secured open platforms are there for designing and implementing the IoT solutions. You will connect, your classroom is secured now. If anybody is entering now, your host is there now, he will control. He will not allow you to enter, to copy anything from this. Such type of secured platforms are there now. It's easy now, IoT solution. Please remember, friends, now I am showing you one chart here. Please understand. Now we'll see this development in the Internet of Things. 9 billion devices around the world are currently connected to the internet, including computers and smartphones. Meaning what it is, friends? The number of connected devices exceeding the number of people on the earth. That's because each person is connected, he is 2 to 3 devices to the net, meaning his desktop, laptop, mobiles. Can you please tell me what is going on? Because you'll see the number is expected to 9 billion, 50 billion devices to reaching 1 trillion devices shortly, friends. The economic rewards, you'll ask, we will get the economic rewards, $2.7 trillion to $6.2 trillion annually by 2025. Meaning you'll see the industrial revolution taking place at a greater pace with digital transformation. Meaning you'll see, friends, here, the dynamic response, smartness, compactness of the system is increased because of the huge development in the VLSI technology. Then you will see in VLSI technology, the MADAS, powerful processors are there. You see how much powerful processors are there, I will show you. The number of transistors on a chip increases from thousands to billion. CPU speed, friends, increases from kilohertz, megahertz, gigahertz, terahertz. Speed is increased. Everything calculation can be done by the processors. You don't need to worry for anything. Everything they will do. Now we'll see this number of transistors in the chip are. You'll see it will show from the 4-bit processor to Itanium processor, 64-bit processors. The number of transistors on the small chip is 2,252, increased to millions and billions. CPU speed, when it is introduced, 4-bit processor, speed is 740 kilohertz. Now it is gigahertz to terahertz. Speed is very fast. Response time is very fast. Meaning what it is, transformation taken place slowly in recent past, drastically in very shorter period, more than you can imagine. School education and educational system is also changed drastically from Gurukul system to smart classroom to now e-classroom. Teacher role, Gurukul system, smart classroom, e-classroom system is a large and requires remarkable change. Let's have a brief outlook of this teaching methodology in the Indian mythology, what it is. You'll see, friends, very quickly I will show you the Gurukula, what you will call a residential schooling. As I have told you, prince and princess, they will go to the guru's ashram. They will be with the gurus. They will do all sevas, meaning housework, and then they are learning. That time, students are called not students, shishyas, very favorite shishyas. That time, the guru is sitting at the top. Shishyas are sitting at the down with a neat, cultured dresses. Now it is opposite. Students are sitting in the desk. Teacher has to stand 1 hour. He has to teach. So you know, way to Gurukula. Where is the Gurukula? Gurukula is in the forest. You have to come across so many things. Animals are there. You have to pass over that. Correct? Then ultimately what it is, you'll see the great Krishna is Krishna Balarama, Rama Lakshmanas. How they are studying with the gurus. You'll see this post, you know, how making shishas in the feet of gurus. Only those are, you know, things we have seen in the Gurukul systems. Meaning the shishas are near to the gurus and he will learn, correct? Very learn. Okay, we are, you see, guru is a prominent role. Guru is a prominent role. All shishas are following him. Also teaching is by touching. Now you will touch any one student, then it is one kiss. Only offline, okay? Then Gurukula, love and affection is more towards the animals also. You'll see more animals. Students are playing with animals. Now anyone is doing like this. Difficult, correct? Also, you will see the Aristotle and Alexander. The big story is there. I will not tell you. You will read this. Crossing the flooded river when both are traveling. Then how, this is very nice story is there. between the Alexander and the Aristotle. Shishya is also having a big respect on the guru. Guru is also having the big respect to the student. Such things are there, olden days. Ekalavya and Drona, you are seen. Ekalavya, when the Dronacharya asked the thumb, he couldn't give a donation, even though he is not studied with the Drona. Then you will see this postprint. Rama Lakshmana are performing the Vishwamitra's ashramas, sevas. Any student will do, no one will do like this. Shanmugam, it is working smoothly?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Now we'll see, friends. Now we are in the.
Sir, 1 minute, sir. Sir, kindly unmute yourself, sir. Now. Sir, kindly unmute yourself, sir. Somchekar, sir. Your voice is not audible. Sir, unmute yourself.
Now only unmuted or long back?
Now only, sir.
Huh.
But your voice is clear for the past half an hour. It's no issue, sir.
So now it is, no, immediately you have to tell me. Otherwise, I don't know, please. Okay, I'm sorry.
Yes, sir.
Gurukul systems, all they are studied, they know it, our previous slides? From where I stopped, tell me.
Up to this, we heard already.
Now we'll see, friends. Now we are in the modern Gurukul residential schooling systems. Meaning you have seen the Gurukul system long back. There it is, we are with the gurus. Now we are in the bonded, like IIT is also what we will call modern Gurukul, where the students are the classroom. Bonded. 50 is more now. And you will see the modern Gurukul system also, what we will call the residential school. Still, we are having the disciplines. The teacher is again teaching to student and well-dressed. And also, they are well-disciplined while studying as well as while taking the food. In C hostel, how they are taking the food. Now, this culture is gone now because the technology changed. Widened. You'll see now the modern school, you'll see what you will call English schools, what we have seen now, the tremendous changes, friends, correct? Compared to the modern school, you'll see the load-bearing capacity increased in terms of the books, carriage, and concept of co-education, meaning everyone will sit. Now you'll see now students are also making the homework, correct? Yeah, how many have finished the homework, you'll ask, all they will show their tabs. because they will copy by one or the other. Previously, what they are doing, they are writing by themselves. As I told you, the writing is a skill art. We are taking a lot of things. Now it is, that thing is gone. Also, you will see, friends, now one more slide I am showing you. After finishing, teacher is asking to take the notes. How they are taking, you will see, they are taking in the mobiles. Nobody interested to write. Meaning, the only white sheet, okay? Now we'll see in the modern school or a smart school. In modern school, each table is equipped with the tabs. Also, you'll remember students are learning by themselves. We'll see in all the things. All are loaded things, it is. All tabs are loaded. What is hearing? Shanmugesh? Shanmusundar? Hello? Hello?
Yeah.
Any problem?
No, sir.
Now you'll see, friends, we are in the modern school or a smart school. The teacher role you will see now. You don't expect you are a professor, you are an assistant professor, associate professor. We are only facilitator or a mentor. The students are learning by themselves. You'll see here, the students are learning by themselves by touching that. It will give a lot of information to the students. Then you'll see here, now in this digital schools or a classroom, we are using the various ways to teach the students, correct? Now also you'll see the smart board teaching is a very effective. Currently, the teacher only will, without chalk and without board, he will also not write. Only it is a multi-screening. She will touch any button, it will open. Children will also learn by touching the each icons. It will give a lot of information to the students. Only she has to guide them as and when required if the students will not understand. This is a smart board teaching, and also we are seeing in the weather report. The multi-screens will open and you will possible to explain to student multi-screen. But you will see some of the Wacom device, many things, multi-screens. You will use and close and you will draw the sketch nearby, explain to students. Smart board teaching. Video conferencing using the various modes, correct? No need to sit here. You will sit it in anywhere in the India. You will connect through IoT concepts. You will see now how students are expressing, asking the questions. All are, you know, virtually. Sometimes in the digital school, in the room only. You know, all students are talking themselves, discussing themselves, and talking themselves, and teacher is doing something. All these type of platforms are there now. You no need to restrict the student to listen to you. They will learn themselves. Leave them. You know, you make them groups and leave them, let them learn. You'll assist them as and when required. Such type of thing we see here now. So teacher is teachers now. Students are all around. She's teaching in the middle. Teachers are in middle. When they will do mistake, you'll correct. Otherwise, no need. Now digital teaching, active learning, what it is? All they will sit around the table. Teacher is at the center. You will monitor how they are learning all these things. Then you will guide them. But you will see now, friends, here it is a active learning here, digital school. It requires the more number of facilities, meaning more number of tabs, more number of powerful connectivity, many things, correct? Here, teacher should be upgraded to this type of things. And student can ask any question during this. And you are in a position to teach them and clarify their doubts. Meaning you have, then sometimes what happened, no, here, teachers are also learner along with the students. Meaning one-to-one, it is going on in the active learning class. Then if you ask me, what are the things are there in the smart classrooms or digital classrooms? Correct. Somebody asked this, you know, if I'm talking about the physical digital classroom, it is the lecture podium with the inbuilt amplifier and mics, computers, laptops, notebooks, notepad, interfaced with internet to all the desks. Smart board and a smart LED, high definition TVs, whiteboard with a marker, pen, as and when required. This is used as I have told you, our laptop screen used as a the board to mark anything or used as a screen like this. Then LCD monitor, projection system, powerful projection system. Again, it is a virtual. As and when you will project it, then you will move it. Meaning it is what you will call virtual projection systems. Then remote control facilities like a laser pointer, PowerPoint presenter, slide changer, wireless mouse, and biometric machines. Attendance, how they are taking in IIT Madras, you will believe it or not, in each classroom, 150 students. The class hours is only 50 minutes. We'll never take the attendance. Whenever your semesters will start, you will tell to your academics, we are taking this subject and this student. Then they will load all the names in the biometric machine. They will give one to you. Then only as soon as you'll go to class, you will circulate them from first desk to other. They will make the biometric attendance. They also it is reducing the proxies. Now PA system and a sound system, powerful PA systems and a sound systems. Then document cameras and visualizers. The well-designed classroom format. I'll show you the seating arrangement, how it is in the digital classrooms. Then large number of teaching assistants. This is very important. As I have told you, know, so many mentors are required when the large number of groups are there. Always you'll remember, friends, you don't think they will listen what you're talking. You leave them in the group-wise. You know, four or five groups you'll make. Let them talk by themselves. Let them learn, you know. That such things gives us the more motivations to student to learn. Okay? Then internet connected printers, when they want anything, they will take the Wi-Fi systems, then a video conference, high definition cameras and screens, many more, much more like this, correct? Now you'll see, friends, this is a some format of the designed digital classrooms. You see now how round table, any format you'll adapt, look here, any format, round table, or like this tables, or like this L-shaped tables. Meaning, then one more thing you'll see, in the classroom itself, let them eat, let them take the tea, whatever they will do. These are the features of digital classroom. You know, they feel free to study in the room. That is the one. Then you'll see how they are using the board. Even the teachers are there at the center, they will learn by drawing the figure, all these things. Only you have to monitor, mentor. Then you'll see, you don't think they have to learn in the classroom. They will learn by doing exercise, you'll see. Whatever it is, you know, they will do anywhere, taking the coffee. Then also you will see now things are going on every day by day. What we teach long back. Still now in our engineering, we are teaching some of the machine tools which are not used at all. Now, because we are in the era of computers, everything is controlled by computers. But we are teaching without computer machine tools, lathe machine, drilling machine, milling machine. Here it is. All are controlled through the, you know, G code and M codes. Such thing one I am showing you here, you see. Summary at the end of the computer class. Due to the recent technological advances, everything I taught you about computer is no longer valid. Because if I teach the 4-bit processor, then 8-bit processor will come. If you teach the 8-bit processor, 16-bit will come, 64-bit will come. Meaning you will teach the basic and leave them, let them learn the advanced thing, what is going on around by themselves, by browsing in the net. They will do themselves. Because so many facilities are there. One more thing you'll remember, friends. In e-learning, the student have the flexibility to choose by themselves the different modes. If, for example, if you type the anything, they will get the 100 teacher are teaching. They will choose by themselves anything which is good for them. Such things are going on now. If you'll ask me the distinct relation changes for the teachers in digital classroom, many things are changing. For centuries, a direct instruction was the pedagogy of the day. The teacher held the position of absolute authoritative power and was the holder, the dispenser of knowledge. On the other hand, students are supposed to work to achieve the curricular objectives designed and assessed by the teacher. Later, student has to memorize the information and demonstrate understanding of the taught principle during the examination. As the extrinsic motivator, teacher will announce pass and fail, correct? Long back. In contrast, the digital age has made a tremendous changes in the education. Classrooms today are no longer confined to one specific educational theory or limited by the physical space. Education is no longer just about delivering the curriculum, but it is an engagement, learning, interactive learning are the key today. It is achieved by providing the large number of data, facilities, ideas to enhance the thinking abilities and the problem solving and arriving solutions, alternatives, and many things. In the digital age, teachers are the learner with their students through the co-learning and collaboration. These methods form the basis of personalized learning. Shanmugh Sundar, I'm in the line.
Yes, sir. We are here, sir.
I'm in the line. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Then we'll see now students and teacher, both they share, collaborate, create information with a simple keystroke, meaning by clicking the mouse or video conferencing. Correct? Now, you no need to meet the friend. We are going to their houses. No need. You'll click one button, we will connect to the teacher. The changing role of the teacher in the digital age can be characterized by three distinct relationship changes. between teacher and student, teacher and curriculum, teacher and pedagogy. Teacher with student, we'll see how it is now. The 21st century student will expect the 21st century learning environment. And the 21st century teacher to see him different role as a facilitator. He is only facilitator, not anything. He is only mentor. So the mindset of the teacher has to change in terms to adapt any type of student behaviors. And ultimately, aim is to motivate for active involvement and learning.
Yes, sir. Good morning.
Only that is our duty. So note, the learning environment is flexible and dynamic, meaning no longer it is restricted to classroom, class timing, and is extended to home, hostels, so that more freedom for the student is given to learn at any time and any place. But you'll give this much freedom to students. No, don't make the student to come to classroom and sit with you and learn. Not like this now. Technology is changing now. Because they want like this. The who want now? Student community want. Student want means teacher has to do it. Because we are for them. That is the one now, that concept. Exam evaluation is also continuous and mostly online quizzes. Semester online exams. The madam is telling copying all these things. We can't do anything now. We have to adapt. Even though now we'll remember who will copy and write the exam, he is not as good as who will learn by themselves by attending the classes. 100% I will tell you, large difference is there because, you know, it is inbuilt qualities of the student. They'll only copy, they'll search the book. But who learned, he will write good. At least we have to target for the 50% of the student, not the 100% of the students. All related materials, class notes, PPTs, assignment, ebook copies, charts, graphs are available in the Moodle along with NPTEL lectures. See now how much benefits students are getting. The teacher and curriculum will see moving from teacher-centered perspective to student-centered perspective in the fashion-driven classroom. Please remember, friends, previously we are making the BOS and we are doing ourselves. What we know, we are teaching. What student want, we are not teaching because we don't know that. But now it is not like this, friends. Please remember, now teacher and curriculum, how we are doing previously, sitting all young, you know, all senior faculty and making the syllabus. What he knows, what he studied, and what he studied from the book, he will put that as a textbook, that as a reference book, and that as a subject. Now, no, friends, no, please remember, it is a student-centered learning. Refocuses on the interest of the child rather than others involved in the education process. Meaning, what we are doing involves the student actively during the BOS meeting, which makes the constructivity area of education. What is this? I will tell you. Student, what they want, you have to ask them. You will give the freedom to talk with us during the syllabus formation. That is the one thing what is going on now. So, honor the importance of student voice and recognize that it is a central to the learning experience for every student. In the student-centered classroom, students choose what they will learn, how they will learn, and how they will access their learning. The true center of correlation of the school subject is not science, nor literature, nor history, nor geography, but the child's own social activities. Student-centered learning requires students to be active, responsible participants in their learning. Now we'll see if the teacher and if you'll ask the pedagogy, if the pedagogy is the art of science educating, then the relationship between the teacher and pedagogy has changed dramatically in the digital age. Assessment practices, professional development opportunities, and a stronger understanding of how students learn best are reshaping the relationship between the teacher and their craft. assessment practices have moved from assessment of learning to assessment for learning, from a teacher-directed assessment to peer and self-assessment. Advances in digital technologies have created a complex assessment experience, such as a game-based assessment and online collaborative problem-solving or a virtual reality. A wider variety of participants are invited into the assessment cycle, including peers and outside experts. Then I'll tell you some of the amazing facts of teaching learning process. Now, what is going on around the world? Currently, the institutions are like this. Students can come to class anytime and go out at any time. No dress code. Dress code is only for the teachers. Student can ask any questions. Teacher has to answer, meaning he has the multidimensional, as I have told you, or he has to learn along with the students. Then no need to take any notes, because you have to give lecture notes, ebook, PPT, videos, then other sources to students. Now, parallel thinking, sleeping, reading newspaper, messaging, etc. are allowed in the classroom, but teachers are not allowed in the examinations. 24/7 high-speed internet facility in the hostel room for advanced learning. They want like this, friends, we are providing. What will you do now? Because it is a technology now. Now we'll see no restriction on entry and exit time to hostel rooms. Anytime they will go, anytime they will come and sleep. Now we'll see boys are not allowed in the ladies' hostel, but ladies are allowed in the boys' hostel for deliberate discussions and many things. Anytime they will come to our office room, or even then what they will do, they will call through mobile phones to ask their doubts. Whatever the position you are there, you have to answer them. They want like this because it is a curriculum now. Now it is a, students are doing, you know, previously I am calling my professor, I am afraid what he is doing, how he is doing, where is he, I am asking. Now students know, anytime they will lift, they will ask the question. Whatever the doubts they are having, you have to answer. Exams, free choice for the student. In a variety. Right. Online, offline, you know, with book, without book, whatever they will ask, you will give. This is a mandate. Later, teacher evaluation through student. If your evaluation is not good, then many things will happen. You know it already. Then now we are thinking, the children's, you know, our children's, our students will come to morning classes 8 o'clock without taking the food. Then the big meetings are taking place. How to feed the children's? What are the methods? Because, you know, what happened now, 7:45, you will go to our mega mess. All students will be in the big queue. This will affect to the first class. Then many wardens, all they're expecting, will give the students pockets in their rooms, or, you know, make the, you know, bread jams, all these things ready. When they will come to the food court, they will pick and they will go while driving in the cycle, they will eat or in the classroom. Classroom food is allowed. Many teachers are not opposing this. Let them eat it in the classroom, no problem. Without the food, they will not concentrate on the teaching learning process. Such things are there. Then a lot of facilities to students. Free gym, free swimming, you know, all free. For teacher, all are chargeable. Now we'll see complete online. Online payment, online paying, online learning, all online is for the student. Now we'll see huge stipend. In spite of that, all huge stipend. Very limited work. These are all the government things. We can't do anything, friends. Now, quickly, I will tell you the things, what is going on in the online teaching. It is a tremendous changes are taking place in the digital technology. As we have seen, we are moving now to the digital India. in a digital India, many things are happening very good through the advancement in the telecommunication things. For example, now you have seen the many things, digital India concepts. Everything can be clear-cut as well as transparent in the government policies. Correct, many things are there. Pradhan Mantri, EPDS, if you see the EPDS, and all documents you have to store in the your DigiLock. Many advancements are there, you know. Then you no need to go to pay anything to their workplace. You will sit inside and use your apps, mobile apps, you will play it. Many things are happening. Now, you know, beginning online teaching may be the resist from the student as well as faculty. The later one day we have to be with the online teaching, as because the very easy accessibility. Student will sit anywhere and they will learn. The meanwhile, you remember they lost many things, but you don't bother about that. Now, what is that is technology is now the driving force behind the evolution. As a new and better things come out, we have to adapt to them and not to resist, as because sometimes change our entire lifestyle. Please remember, friends, now we are getting a lot of time. We have to prepare the slides. Then also we are not what you will call management or institutes will not bear for the your expenses like buying the, you know, laptops and buying the Wacom devices or buying your what you will call the mics and all these things. You have to pay from your pocket and be ready. Because now the technology is coming like this, you know. If you are not having these devices, very difficult to address your things to the students. They want like this now. Also, we know that, you know, friends, I will tell you, when engineering drawing is introduced using the computers, correct, you know, AutoCAD and all these things, so many resistances there. Now, we as a teacher, very comfortable in teaching the engineering drawing, all these things using the AutoCAD and many things. Beginning, it is a resistance is there, but automatically we are adjusting ourselves. Tremendous change in the Gurukul system and a digital system. Knowledge is very much essential to tackle the complex situation in the competitive educational world. Still require a more cutting-edge research in a diverse areas to deliver better in the digital age. As I have told you, the networking issues, connectivity issue is a very big, huge thing India is facing. But how to address these things, we have to think. Then as Madam G noted, you know, mass copying. This may happen. How to overcome? Now, as I have told, you know, we are thinking in the different fashions to attempt it. Also, you know, some of the universities, what they will do, they will teach online teaching, you know, learning process all through online. But exam, they are making the physically by attending the examination hall nearby or in some engineering colleges nearby. They are taking the things. They are doing that things. Let us join the hand to build the country strong enough to compete with the world market by adopting the Modi's vision, make in India. Because in US, all this thing, all our classroom teaching is taking place nowadays. Jai Hind, Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu. Thank you. And all the teachers, you know, this time I'm offering the one NPTEL course. This is also, I'm telling you, I'm sitting in front of, you know, screen, I'm talking, you know. This is a 30 hours lecture, I'll hydraulics and pneumatics, very effective course. And here you'll see the many industries are participating, DML, HAL, VSCC, many things. Now already, you know, 225 students as well as faculty registered for this course. The very good course. I'm requesting your students or your children are there to register for this course. Thank you one and all. Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu.
Tanmugesh. Yeah, thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
I will take the questions from the audience. Anyone is there, can you please talk with me?
Sir, is there any ethics or that while taking?
What type of ethics you want? Please.
Punjan Mukuma, sir, your voice is not audible. Punjan Mukuma, sir.
Hello.
Yeah, I think it's having a network issue, sir. Yeah.
Okay, no problem. Anyone? Many teacher faculties are there. Then you are seeing me also, you know, offline now, correct? Then if apart, then one more thing, you know, I use this Shanmugasundar platform to invite you. I am also conducting two courses like FDP and the smart manufacturing and fluid power system. Like shortly, all faculty are invited for this. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Any
thank
other?
Thank you. I think this oil hydraulics and pneumatics is a very very much informative course.
Yeah.
Sir.
Thank you. Please. You know, very rigorous course that it is. You see the syllabus, all this, a very rigorous course. You are a student.
This year only you started, right, sir?
This year only we are launched because of the many industries are all asking.
Yes, sir.
This is only from the tailor-made. Okay. But faculty as well as a teacher who will teach this is a very useful course. Okay. You people also register and see how it is. Okay.
Yeah, thank you for
the opportunity. As I have told you, tell me.
Sir, that smart manufacturing process, when will you start, sir?
That shortly, you know, within one, you know, next year, 2020, already two course I am conducting. Yes. You will request you all, you will join.
Okay. Zion course, right, sir?
Zion course. No, this is not a Zion course. It is like this, you know, what you are doing, FDP course.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. It's a very wonderful presentation you shared your enormous knowledge in digital manufacturing, sorry, digital teaching methodology to our participants. Yeah. I think the participants got benefited for this lecture.
This is only general talk. Okay, general talk.
General.
Thank you very much.
Shall
I leave now?
Thank you, sir.
I'll leave. Thank you very much. Namaste to all.
Thank you, sir.